Time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by New Stavet, America's leading spray deodorant. The lotion spray deodorant that's like balm to your skin. Ooh, there goes perspiration. Now let's all play What's My Line?
Now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular Broadway columnist, whose voice of Broadway appears in papers from coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
On my left, a great comedian, one of the biggest names in show business, and the man who has just stepped on Arlene France's train, Mr. Fred Allen.
The train wasn't going anyplace, Dorothy. And at my left, ladies and gentlemen, a very young, attractive lady who has kindergarten eyes. You know, kindergarten eyes with those small pupils. Miss Arlene Francis.
Better to see you with. And on my left, the distinguished publisher of Random House Books and columnist for This Week magazine, Mr. Bennett, Cerf.
And on my left, a man who isn't satisfied by being a great news commentator and panel moderator, but in addition thereto, has just been appointed constable of Harris, New York, so you can look for a new crime wave in Westchester. Mr. John Daly.
They wouldn't dare. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. And panel, we're up to some new tricks tonight. I would ask you, if you would, to blindfold yourselves while I finish our normal little introduction. We're departing from our usual rules, but it's the same play, really. We've got some nice people with some interesting occupations, and we think we'll give the panel a rough time of it. We'll also have a famous guest challenger later on, but right now we want to introduce a challenger to the panel, and we've asked them to blindfold themselves because we're very much afraid that there is an area of recognition in name and in figure and visage which might give too much away. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes. Right.
Good, then we'll allow our first challenger come and sign in, please. And now would you be good enough to join me over here? You sit right here. We'll give the panel a chance to think out loud in the dark. How'll that be?
John, are we to do one question at a time as we do with the celebrity
guest? No, we'll play according to the normal rules for challenges.
All right.
This, you get it and you keep it until you get a no answer. By the way, do you know how we score this operation?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's fine. Then we'll let our viewers at home and our friends here in the theater, perhaps they already know, but the viewers at home particularly know exactly what your line is. That having been done, we will announce that you are self-employed and begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Well, are your lines symmetrical?
Mm-hmm.
Are you known for your appearance as well as for what you do?
That's a very difficult question. If I may, I will try to answer this because it invades an area where we'd want to be fair. I would say that the appearance of our guest would have a quality, certainly on many occasions, which would to some degree clarify or identify. Beyond that, we can't go.
I see.
You do?
Do you work in anything other than a bathing suit when you do what you're most famous for?
Mm-hmm.
You're self-employed.
Yes, mm-hmm, self-employed.
Well, what I'm trying to establish is, do you do some work other than just being beautiful?
Mm-hmm.
Do you perform services?
Do you perform services?
Mm-hmm.
For people?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a professional at what you do?
Mm-hmm.
Do you appear before large numbers of people at one time?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, would sometimes, I would say there, that would be fair mm-hmm. to say sometimes, Dorothy.
Can they be both men and women?
Mm-hmm.
Does anything that you do benefit children, too?
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. Does anything benefit children, too?
Benefit or entertain?
Yes, I would say so. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We had a small conference there for a minute, Dorothy.
Do you appear on television?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, yeah.
Do you ever appear on stages or lecture platforms?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You're going great. But where are you?
I'm nowhere. All right.
I can't say no.
Do you work in and around New York?
Mm-hmm.
Do you work other places, too?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll get out fast. Let's get to the physical. Are you blonde?
Are you blonde?
Mm-mm.
No? Mm-hmm. I don't know. These things are way over my head, you know. But if you say no, we'll flip a no card. That's one down and nine to go.
What does she look like to you, John?
Beg your pardon?
Couldn't we have a qualifying answer from you? What does she look like to you?
Well, actually, this is something where I must yield to our guest, Arthur, because I don't quite understand the terminology used by your sex with respect to hair coloring. So we make it one down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
I mean, she's not bald-headed.
No, certainly not, Fred.
Are you, do you appear on a regular television show?
Mm-mm.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Is it possible that you are in a business other than show business?
Mm-hmm.
But you are a professional. Is it something that women would use more than men, your services?
Mm-hmm.
Do you work indoors?
Mm-hmm.
Are you in industry?
Mm-hmm.
I wish you hadn't said yes. Industry. Would you be connected in any way with apparel, as in a department store? What happened? Everybody go home?
Yeah. I made the connection.
I would say that the question, would you be connected in any way with apparel, would have to be answered affirmatively, yes.
Then you have you deal in products?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a product that a woman would wear?
Mm-hmm.
Well, would she wear it above the waist?
Mm-hmm.
Would she wear it above the neck?
Mm-hmm.
Would she wear it sur la tête? Would she wear it on the head?
Mm-hmm.
Are you in the millinery business?
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, it's not Mr. John, I'm positive.
Mrs. John.
Now, wait a minute. Is there something besides hats that you work with?
Mm-hmm.
Do you also make clothes?
Mm-hmm.
Did I ever do a fashion show for you?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a name that is known from coast to coast?
Yeah.
Are you Madame Lily Dache?
Yes! Thank you very much. It was very nice to have you with us on What's My Line. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Good night.
I'm sure you would have gotten that one.
Well, that wasn't as rough as we thought it would be. All right, gentlemen, will you sign in? Let's see what our panel can do with a double challenger. You see, we're playing all sorts of tricks on you tonight. Harold Sander, right? And Art Asquith, right? Arthur, you get in the middle, and Harold, you get over there, and let's do this. Where are you from, Harold?
I'm from Little Valley, New York, sir.
Little Valley, New York? Where are you from, Arthur?
Little Valley, New York. Also.
Little Valley, New York. Well, that's fine. You must both come from the same town.
There you go.
Well, I tell you what, the panel usually gets and likes to get a chance to get a close look at people who are going to be the challengers. So would you take a hike together down in front of the panel for me?
Bill, Mr. Asquith.
Mr. Sanders.
How are you doing?
Hello. Nice to see you. Imagine getting two young men. How are you?
Hello. How are you?
Stay right where you are, thank you.
All right, come clean. What do you do?
All right, gentlemen. Over here, if you will, and sit down next to me.
Boys didn't represent America in the Davis Cup matches, did you?
Well, that's something
We're
you can find. Something you can find out later, Fred. Now, do you two gentlemen know how we score this operation?
Yes, sir.
Good. If you know how to do that, let's let the people at home and our friends in the theater know exactly what your line is. All right. We will announce. Salary. They are salaried, and I would add, in all fairness, that they are both college students, and this is a summer occupation, but they have performed it in earlier summers, and it's a part of their lives.
They're a big smash.
They're a big smash, that's right. So, let's begin the general questioning with Fred Allen.
They're not. I think it's too funny for me, John. I don't know. They're not Lily Dache's sons, by any chance. Well, I don't know. Is there a product involved in what you gentlemen...
Yes, sir.
There is a product?
Yes, sir.
I'm not using the word loosely by any chance. Is this a product that might be found in the home, the average home?
Yes, sir.
It could be found in the home. Is this something that that could be fit into the pocket of a man's suit?
I beg your pardon, Fred?
Is this something, I mean, in size, is it something that could conceivably be held in the pocket of a man's suit?
Yes, I think it could be held in the pocket of a man's suit.
In other words, it's smaller than a small boy's head.
Sometimes it's smaller than a small boy's head, yes.
But it could go into the pocket of a person's suit, a man's suit. If Dorothy and Arlene would let me look in their purses, do you think I would be able to find one of the things?
No.
I wouldn't find them.
No, you wouldn't.
There's almost everything in there, John. I've looked in there. Arlene's especially.
I think we're safe, though, Fred. That's one down and nine to go, Miss Fred.
But you do have to work together on this job.
Well, they do work together on it. It is not absolutely necessary that they perform together, but they do.
I see. The audience roared, so I thought they were both the fore and back end of a horse or something at a holiday entertainment park. Does this product consume itself, or is it consumed?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it consumed by eating?
It can be.
Some can be, sometimes.
It can be eaten? Are you intimating that it's also used for something else other than to be eaten?
Well, I think...
To rub it in your hair or something?
I think Harold and Arthur will agree with me that whereas it can be consumed sometimes by eating, it also on other occasions can be consumed by other means. Wouldn't you say that was fair? Yes.
Hmm. Was it ever alive? Or is it alive at the time you handle it?
Yes.
Which question? Oh, you want? Is this a double?
I thought I'd get them both in.
Well, you got them both in. Now you decide what the yes is for.
Is it alive? No. I'll kill you.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr.
Bennett, aren't you mean?
When this animal was alive, gentlemen, was it the kind of animal that you would not be ashamed to have in or near your own house?
Why should you be ashamed of an animal?
Well, if it's a cockroach, you wouldn't want to.
When you say in or near, you mean such as a... We don't want to give you a false answer on this. It's
a
pet
farm,
of some kind.
I was thinking that I wouldn't think they'd be connected with skunks or vermin of any kind.
Oh, I see. Well, I guess in that...
Is it? Can I eliminate the skunk and vermin families from
our
discussion?
Yeah, you can do that.
Please do.
Would this be an animal that might be found around a farm?
Yeah.
Yes, I think so.
Does it, when it is around a farm, does it graze peacefully in the pastures?
Oftentimes.
Yeah, actually, this is only, as we said, sometimes it could, you know, it could be, and sometimes.
Is it an animal with four legs?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, yeah.
Is sometimes?
It, sometimes?
Yeah.
Is it, I mean, sometimes it has four legs?
Yeah.
Four legs? Is that what you were saying? That sometimes it has not got four legs.
Are you asking?
Well, if it sometimes has four legs, then sometimes it must not have four legs.
Conference, please.
Yeah. Conference.
Could we have a conference?
You may have
Bennett,
15 seconds.
I just wish to remind you of one fact.
What?
This can be folded up and put in a pocket.
Is this a bug of any sort?
A bug?
Yeah, flea or something.
A flea?
Yes, no.
That makes it $3.70.
Thank you, Dorothy.
When did you fold up a flea?
I'll tell you what. I'm going to give you 1 minute more because I don't think you're getting very close to this.
I don't either. It's when it's alive, it can have four legs or not, right? Mm-hmm. But when you deal with it, it's dead, right?
Yes.
Well, is it?
Yeah.
Is it in some other form? I mean, you're not taxidermists, are you? Yes, you are not taxidermists?
Yes. Yes, they are not taxidermists, no.
Has the animal been through some sort of a process by the time it gets to you?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So.
Is this process designed to make it edible, or is that accidental?
Yes, I would say yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, is it something like hot dogs or sausages or something?
Hot dogs?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah.
Oh. Well, is it in the delicatessen family?
Sometimes.
Do the people you know eat this?
No.
And I'm going to fold all the cards over on the basis of time.
Fred has an idea.
If it occasionally has four legs, it could be an occasional quadruped.
Well,
Does it lie still when you eat it? That's what I want to know.
No, actually, this is very funny. You're Harold and Arthur will now tell you what they are.
We'd like to dedicate this little number to garbage men all over the United States. And our driver, Mr. Lynn Osgood.
Oh, they're garbage boys.
Yeah, there you go. All right, now the identifying theme.
We are your jolly G-men. We come around each day. We pick your garbage up for you. And haul it right away. We bring a cheerful greeting to all you happy folks. We brighten up your cloudy days with little songs and jokes. And now your cans are empty, the entertainment's through. It's time for us to move along. We bid you all adieu.
Men. One of them goes to Ithaca College, the other to Wayne University, and these two young men don't have to worry about their future.
John, I can't think of any agent who would refuse them a job.
Oh.
Thank you, Bennett, sir.
We got something for you fellas to come back and pick up. And we'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just... We come to the special feature of the program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which, once again tonight, my friends on the panel are blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place again, panel?
Mm-hmm. Yes, back in place.
Thank you. Will you come in, Mystery Challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we have different rules. You ask one question each in turn, going clockwise. And let's begin this questioning with Miss Arlene Francis.
Have you appeared in the theater?
No.
Oh, say!
Girl, one down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, there goes my idea of Davis Cup players. This is not a question. We may assume that you're a girl, may we not?
You want to ask this as a question?
Yes, are you a girl?
I think so.
Yes, it would be yes, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, are you in any form of the amusement industry?
Yes.
Mr. Allen?
Are you in television?
Yes.
Have you appeared in pictures?
No.
Two down?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Cerf.
Do you do a regular television show?
Yes.
Are you a comedian?
No.
We will have a short recess now so that our guest can store up a little energy to keep on disguising her voice. That's three down and
do
seven to go.
A weekly television show?
Yes.
You say you are not a comedian. Are you a dramatic actress?
That makes it four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Do you, by any chance, with that funny little voice, sing?
Good girl.
Miss Kilgallen.
Do you sing on a show that has been off for the summer, or that you have been off of for the summer?
Yes.
Mr. Allen.
Are you a friend of Mr. Gobel's?
Yes.
Perky Pecky.
Perky Pecky.
You never could remember my name, Mr.
I couldn't remember it in Hollywood either.
No fair, John. I guessed her last week. When I was
You've been guessing me all year, Dorothy.
That's why we thought we'd fool Dorothy, and we did. I was afraid of Dorothy. I didn't think Fred was going to do it.
And Arlene knows me, too. I didn't know what to do, you know.
You did it very well.
I do a Japanese accent, but Debbie Reynolds already did that, so,
Let's hear you do a Japanese.
Oh, no. She's much better than I am.
well, sing for us, then.
Well, I could do that. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you, Miss Peggy. It's wonderful. Give our best to George. We'll see you, will you?
Perky
Peggy King. And now would you sign in, please, sir, as a final challenger panel, and I give you full and fair warning that there is very little time left, so you must put your best thinking caps on. Sal Solanto, is that right, sir?
Where are you from?
New York City.
Mr. Solanto is from New York City. Come with me. And you sit right down, Mr. Solanto. You know how we score things?
Yes, sir.
Fine, then let's let the people at home, our friends here in the theater, know exactly what your line is. Panel, you have a little more than a minute and a half. Mr. Solanto is salaried. We'll begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Well, if we were still doing free guesses, Mr. Solanto, I would say you had something to do with a barbershop, have you?
Nope.
One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
Nope.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Allen.
Do you work for some branch of the government?
Nope.
That makes it three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
Are you in the clergy?
Nope.
Four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Are you in something to do with hospitals or charity?
Nope.
Five down and five to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Have you anything to do with education?
Nope.
Six down and four to go, Mr. Allen.
Are you unemployed?
Seven down and three to go, Miss Francis.
I can't think of anything else
He's
that
not
is
even here.
Making. Do you have anything to do with museums?
Nope.
Nope. That's eight down and two to go, Mr. Cerf.
You said you have nothing to do with any kind of government. Is that correct?
That's right.
That's right.
Do you have anything to do with teaching people anything?
Nope.
That's nine down and one to go, and I'm going to call it ten down and no more to go because you aren't even beginning on it. Mr. Solanto is the penguin keeper at the Bronx Zoo, which, as you know, is operated by a nonprofit organization known as the Zoological Society. I want you to meet Flash Kilgallen. She's going to run for an aeroplane because play that her husband produces, Dick Colmar, Plain and Fancy, is opening in Los Angeles, the Biltmore Theater tomorrow night, and if she doesn't make this plane, she won't be there. So good night, Dorothy, till next week.
Good night, John. Good night, Fred.
Good night, Dorothy. Happy trip. Good night, Arlene.
Good night. Good night, Bennett.
Good night, Constable Daly.
And good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
Transportation for What's My Line is arranged through American Airlines, America's leading airline, serving 77 major cities throughout the United States, Canada, and Mexico. This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.